You're listening to the Joe Mays and J-Raff Show, giving you weekly sports analysis, opinions, and discussion. Now, here are your hosts, Joe Mays and J-Raff.
Well, good evening, everyone, and welcome to the 136th episode of the Joe Mays and J-Raff Show. I'm one of your hosts, Joe Mays, alongside of me, co-host J-Raff.
Yeah, it's good to be back. We had we had some other things going on. Weren't able to do a show for a few weeks, but it's good to be back, and certainly a different and interesting topic for us tonight.
Yeah, we're avoiding sports in the real world at the time being, which is probably a good thing, as the Stanley Cup playoffs final will feature a team that we don't like, and the Phillies are not playing so well of late. We're going to get into that more next week, but I mean, I guess the one bright spot is the Heat being in the NBA Finals.
Or the Spurs.
The Heat being in the NBA Finals is nice.
Go Spurs, go.
But, you know, there's just, we're getting to the point in the calendar year where it's kind of a dead time for sports. You have baseball, but that's pretty much it.
And the way the Phillies are playing right now, we don't really have
They're kind
baseball.
Of dead as well. So, you know, it's time to fill in some topics here. And we like to dig into our bag of options and with the best of series, we call it, and we just kind of grab a topic from around the sports world and just kind of get some healthy debate going and just talk about you know, good and bad, best and favorite, and that's what we're going to be doing this evening. But we're not even doing anything related to people or sports teams. We're actually going to jump into the realm or switch gears in the form of entertainment. We're actually going to look to Hollywood and talk about what are our favorite sports movies to ever come out. And I think there'll be a lot of, well, I shouldn't say there'll be a lot of debate, because I think you and I are kind of on the same grounds. But when you think historically of people's favorite or the best sports movies to ever come out, a lot of them were made before we were born, and we haven't all gotten to see them yet, even though they get thrown out all the time when you talk about, you know, the best sports movies of all time. I think maybe it'll surprise a lot of people that we haven't seen some of them, or we saw them, but it was so long ago, like we were so young, we haven't seen them since. We didn't even get to, you know, use them in our list that we came up for this evening. But I think it'll be a fun show to talk about sports movies. Anytime you're talking about a list of the greatest or favorite, there's always going to be some agreement and disagreement. So we'll see what we get tonight. But I think it'll be a lot of fun to talk about what we believe are our favorite movies of all time in the sports world. So that's what we're going to do this evening.
Yeah, and like you said, it should be a good show. Lots of I was saying when we were kind of comprising our lists here, this is one of the harder things, narrowing it down into 10. You know, when we've done our best ofs before, you know, I've had some kind of statistics to go back on, you know, and you know, supplement that with just, you know, my opinions and things like that. This is strictly my opinion, you know. So there was nothing to really fall back on. You know, some sports movies that people didn't like, real, you know, or don't have great reviews, I liked. Some that people liked.
I feel like it's the case with movies, right? Regardless of whether they're involved sports or not.
Some that they liked, you know, I didn't really care for. So, and like you said, the majority of them, when we look at lists, if you know, it's awesome that we live in a time where we can just type it in and find a huge list of sports movies. But, you know, it started going back to, like, basically, like, highlight clips of, like, the old Yankees without sound kind of stuff. You know, nope, haven't seen it.
Nope, sorry.
So there's lots of movies that we haven't seen, and, you know, it is interesting to see some of the ones. And, you know, as we're throwing movies out there, you know, ones that we forgot or ones, you know, that we would have been sure that the other person saw, stuff like that. It's pretty good. And there's definitely some on the list that, you know, kind of bringing it up that, all right, now I really do need to see that movie. So yeah, it should be fun to go through our lists.
I think Kelly and I tried to, we set out to watch all of the Academy Award winners. Like, we wanted to watch all the ones that have won you know, best picture of the year. That's a difficult task. Not only because we haven't seen a bunch of them, she's seen probably twice as many as I have, but there's a lot of them I don't want to see. But I, you know, I feel like it's kind of something we should do, although you've already mentioned it. We don't always agree with what, right. You know, critics and Hollywood in general think are the best movies. But that's something that Kelly and I wanted to do. But I think sports genre is one that I've neglected a lot more so than other ones. And this could just because we're talking about it tonight, because you could throw out another genre and be like, oh yeah, there's probably some of the big movies there I haven't seen either. But I looking over, you know, doing the research for this tonight to make sure I didn't miss anything or leave anything out, I was looking over, you know, top lists, and I was like, wow, a lot of these movies that are thrown all the time, quoted all the time, I haven't seen. You know, and for us to be doing a sports radio show for me and us to not have seen some of these, or like I said at the intro, we haven't seen some of these in like 15, 20 years. I don't even know if we can justify saying, I don't even remember, you know, characters' names from some of the movies. I've seen the movie, but it was so long ago, it can't make my favorite. So I have some catching up to do, so I'm going to have to do some Netflix and Amazon Prime searching for a few of these movies that aren't on either of our lists, but probably should be. But again, we got to see them before they can make the list. So before we dive into our list, we want to make sure you're aware of how you can contact us, because I think this could be one of the shows, if there's enough people out there watching, that there'll be some disagreement or shock, or how could you not have seen this, or how could this not be in your top 10, things like that. So we have a bunch of different ways that you can contact us, and Justin's going to start out with some of that information right now.
Yeah, like Joey mentioned, this is definitely a show where we love to hear your take on maybe some of the movies that, you know, you've seen along with us, and your thoughts, you know, whether you like or dislike, you know, kind of compared to some of ours. Also, you know, like you said, there's a number of movies we haven't seen, so we'd love to have your take on maybe some of those movies as well. So one way you can get in touch with us is using the Maze Sandwich Shop hotline, and you can call us at 530-563-6297, again, 530-563-6297. Or you can email us using the Maze Sandwich Shop inbox at joemazeandjraff@gmail.com. Again, joemazeandjraff@gmail.com. And Joey will tell you how you can get in touch with us on social media.
Yeah, you can contact us a variety of ways through the social media sites, primarily Facebook, which we have up during the show, and Twitter likewise. Our Twitter account is @JoeMazeandJRaff. You can send us tweets there. We have Facebook up during the show, like I said, so you can also comment on anything that we post on there, and we will see that during the show. So this evening is definitely one of the prime candidates to get a little discussion going. I know, like last year when we talked about the, you know, greatest all-time baseball players, that generated a lot of discussion. So maybe this will tonight as well. If enough people remember that we're back from the month hiatus, yeah, maybe we'll get a decent amount of people writing in to let us know what they think of our list or what even their list is. Go ahead and throw that at us as well. All right, we don't have any email holdovers from the last show, so we're going to dive right in. Again, this is Best of Series Sports Movies. And before we get to our list, I think it's most important to point out that this is the Best of Series, but when I was developing my list, I wasn't necessarily looking for the best.
Right, absolutely.
Because in my view, there's a stark difference between the best and favorite. The best are kind of ones that should garner awards. Like, there's a bunch of different things that come together to make a movie, and the things that do all of them at a high level, those are generally the best. But usually my favorite don't mix with best, because favorite is just something that I want to entertain me. That's the point of the movie to me. I'm not necessarily always going in trying to learn something or trying to be enlightened about something. It doesn't need to be life-altering. I just want to be entertained. I want to have fun. And that's usually what I'm looking for in a movie. So that's why I went with, these are kind of my top 10 favorite sports movies. And I think you are similar.
Yeah. We have a very similar list when we get to our top 10. They're not all the same, but again, some of that is just because we had to cut it down to 10. It's really tough. Like I said, this is one of the tougher, like narrowing down was one of the tougher ones we had to do.
And I think it's important to start out with, maybe we'll look at one that, a list that goes over some of the best sports movies of all time. And this is truly a best. They were looking for votes and, you know, critics' takes and awards and things like that when they came up with it. And it's kind of the best place to go in terms of finding lists of movies. It's what the American Film Institute does. They had a couple shows on, it was probably 5, maybe even 10 years ago now when they went over the top 100 movies and they broke it down into genre. So they called it 10 Top 10 and they had it for 10 different genres of movies and they picked the top 10 for each genre. And the sports movies, I think I've heard of a lot of them. Again, it's only 10, so that there's some that I haven't heard of. It's kind of shocking, but as I was looking over the list, there were a couple that jumped out at me that I had never even heard of. A lot of them I had heard of, but I hadn't seen all of them, which right. Kind of when I started this journey, I was like, wow, there's some catching up I definitely have to do in terms of sports movies. But the American Film Institute, 10 Top 10 for sports. We'll start at the bottom. Jerry Maguire. I've seen it.
Yeah, I've seen it too. I liked it.
But it's fun. You know, I don't want to take the time to define what makes a movie a sports related or not. If you've seen Jerry Maguire, there's some football thrown in. It's mostly from the view of an agent. And it's also more of a romance movie than sports movie. Just kind of have sports thrown in to kind of give it the plot. But I liked it. I don't know if it deserves to be in the top 10 all time, but it made their list.
I would agree with that assessment. I liked it. It's not in my top 10. And again, I think this is a prime example of a movie that could be considered a good movie or like a great movie or a best of movie that isn't necessarily one of my top 10 favorite movies.
Right.
It's a very good movie.
I enjoyed watching it.
A very good movie. It wasn't one of my while I enjoy it and I like it, it's not one of my top 10 favorites when I had to cut it
it's
down.
It's about a receiver for the Cardinals.
Exactly. Well, and this wasn't even like, you know, Cardinals that tend to be good every now and then.
This is terrible.
This is the Cardinals we've known most of our lives that were awful.
Of course, everyone knows the one famous line from it, show me the money.
Yeah. I thought you were going to use one of the lines from the kid, like, you know, one of those, like, factoids about, like, the human head weighs.
That kid is really cute, but, you know, he's probably, like, 25 now.
Yeah. Hey, yes, that's kind of weird.
That is really, really weird. Okay, now the next two I honestly had never heard of before reading this list. So, number 9 was National Velvet.
Yeah, I didn't know it.
I have no comment on that whatsoever. The next one is a movie about cycling called Breaking Away.
Never
also, sorry, don't know anything about it, never heard of it. Now, number 7 I absolutely had heard of, and I've started to enjoy more recently than I had the first few times I saw it. And again, it's a comedy based around an event. So, I mean, it has the sports element to it, but I don't think that's what you're going back for time and time again. And this one is Caddyshack. It really is a funny movie. It actually got better the more times that I watched it to catch up on everything. So, I just have a lot more respect for it more recently after seeing it a couple times. Does it deserve to be in the top 10? I don't know. That's up for debate. It made this list, though.
Yeah, and I actually have only ever seen clips of Caddyshack. I've never actually seen the whole thing the whole way through. So it's tough for me to kind of rate it. I know it's like one of the classics, and, you know, I probably should watch it sometime. Especially, again, now that you've said you appreciate it or you find it more entertaining now than you did before, that kind of piques my interest a little bit. But same time, you know, obviously I can't list it as one of my favorites if I haven't seen the whole thing. So I can't even really comment on that one too much.
Number 6 I've heard of, The Hustler.
Heard of, never seen
haven't it. Seen it.
Right.
You know, it's about a pool shark. But, you know, other than that, I don't know anything about the film. It's an older movie. Haven't seen it, though. But that was American Film Institute's number 6 sports movie of all time. Now, the top 5 I've heard of, I've seen a few. And these are a lot of the movies that I'm saying I need to see.
Right.
Number 5, Bull Durham. Have not seen it.
I know. But every time you talk about great sports movies, it's one of those that seems to be on almost everyone's list. So I feel like I've got to see it. I have not. And mark that down as one that maybe I can check off this summer when instead of watching real baseball with the Phillies.
Yeah, really.
That's unfortunate, but just kind of where we're at right now.
All right, and number 4, seen it a long time ago, So I didn't want to put it on my list because it's been so long since I've seen it. But it's probably the most famous basketball movie, and that is Hoosiers.
Yeah, seen it, love it, made my list. And we'll talk more about it a little later, but I just absolutely love that movie. And yeah, we'll talk more about that. We'll get back to that one as well.
Number three, again, heard of it, haven't seen it, The Pride of the Yankees.
Yeah, same here. I've heard of it, never saw it.
Number two, again, saw it a long time ago. It is one of the most quotable movies that you'll see. And being from the region we are, it's probably been played more often than you'd care to take it sometimes. But
It's
that is
there
Rocky.
seems to be like a Rocky marathon on one of like the local channels like fairly regularly. I actually of the first four, this is probably the one I've seen the fewest times. Not I don't think it's a spoiler for a movie that's, 40 years old.
Almost 40 years
But
old.
I just think with Rocky losing in Rocky, it's not Rocky one, but in Rocky, I think I choose not to watch that one.
Yeah, it's a bit of
But
a
a lot of
downer.
people would argue that it's the best. Like, and
Right.
one thing that
Well,
people don't, one thing that people like tend to forget is that Sylvester Stallone like made that movie. Like, not I don't mean like, oh, he was important role. Like, no, it was his movie. Like, he came up with a lot of the ideas, and basically I don't know if he produced it or whatever, but he was the one who like it was his movie. And so while he's known as a guy who is big, just kind of a guy who's still probably on steroids, and like admittedly so, he was still able to put together a pretty awesome all-time movie.
And last, and certainly not least, obviously, if it's number one. Unfortunately, I've never seen it.
I've never seen it, but I've heard a number of people and a few people who, in my mind, know a lot about movies. Again, whether or not I always agree with them, have this as probably one of their all-time favorites overall, let alone sports movies.
That would be Raging Bull. Raging Bull, obviously the boxing movie, based on a true story. Came out, what, about probably about 30, 35 years ago or so. De Niro, Pesci, it's a big one in the sports movie world, and unfortunately, neither of us have seen
Right, yeah.
it. I feel like I haven't seen any of the boxing movies. Like, even, like, I've
I've
seen
seen
some of the
some.
Rockies, but it's been so long, like, I
Right,
almost, like, throw
right.
it on the pile, I should watch them again. Raging Bull. All the rewatch the Rocky movies, then what, Cinderella Man, Million Dollar Baby, what, the Hurricane, the Boxer, like there's
Right,
all these
yeah.
tons of
There's a
sports
lot
movies
of
about
them that I
boxing that
haven't
I haven't
seen.
seen.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I haven't seen a lot of those either.
All right, so that's the American Film Institute's top 10 sports movies from, I don't know, I'll say about 5 to 10 years ago. I forget when exactly they did this countdown. But that's theirs. Now let's get to ours. We're gonna start. We kind of listed them top 10, give or take, move some around a couple spots. This is a general idea. We've both seen a number of movies, and a lot of them are sports related. We've already mentioned that there's probably some that we need to see, but of the ones we've seen, these are our favorites. These are ones that if it's on TV, we'll probably end up watching it because we enjoy it. And we'll start with, number 10 and work our way up to number 1. And my number 10, I know, is going to come up on your list as well. And I felt like this one had to be on there because it's one of the first movies I remember watching, and it is one of my favorite sports movies, or just movies in general. And that is The Sandlot. It's such a great movie, such a feel good movie. It has, it ties into baseball, which I think is. I feel like baseball can relate to movies better than a lot of the other sports out there. It's hard to follow. It's easier nowadays, but it's hard to follow hockey and football because of the speed, trying to get the gameplay in. Baseball's a little more leisurely. It's easier to get the framing right and everything, all that goes into making movies. So I feel like baseball is a great one to transfer to film, and The Sandlot was a fun one that I enjoyed growing up, and I still like now. And it has again, I tend to like movies that you can quote a lot, and there's so many great lines from The Sandlot that I knew that that one had to make my list.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree. And again, I'll mention it a little bit when we get to my list. But yeah, Sandlot is absolutely a must-see. And like you said, there are a lot of lines. You know, when we were talking about The Sandlot before the show, we just started rattling off like lines, you know, that we knew from the movie. It's a classic. Also, small thing, I like how at the end it just kind of makes up stories for how each character like goes.
Right.
On. I love movies that do that. I don't know why. I just really do.
They want you to feel like there's
some kind of closure.
Right. Yeah. Even though they made a Sandlot 2, apparently. All right. What about your number 10?
My number 10, the garbage picking, field goal kicking, Philadelphia phenomenon.
Of course, Tony Danza,
Eagles kicker.
He's totally. That is your number 10.
As much as I would love for that to be my number 10.
It's a Disney movie.
It is a Disney movie. I'm actually going to go to another Disney movie. I'm going to go to The Rookie, the one about a science teacher who becomes a Major League Baseball pitcher.
Is that your dream?
Hello. Yeah, actually, it's a biopic of the Justin Raffoff story.
You would have to play for the Devil Rays, I believe, eventually.
I could do that.
Which they don't exist anymore.
That's all technically. Right.
It's changed name.
I'll make it happen.
You'll make it happen.
Yeah.
Okay.
But, yeah, The Rookie, great movie. You know, again, it's kind of like a feel-good story, but that's kind of what I'm looking for in a lot of these sports movies. Maybe that has something to do with the fact that during, like, my childhood and growing up, for most of my sports, like, fan, like, associations, there's been very little happy endings, very few happy endings.
Just one little blip.
Right. So to have happy endings in my sports movies is kind of a requirement.
Yeah, I agree. But you very rarely have movies that end with people being like, well, that's not what I wanted to happen,
right.
Except for Rocky.
Right, exactly.
Okay, so I have seen The Rookie. It didn't make my list, but I enjoyed The Rookie. Number 9 is a more recent movie. It actually is the top grossing sports-related film of all time, and that is The Blind Side. It came out in 2009. It's about Michael Oher, who has moved on from the Baltimore Ravens, but he is an offensive tackle in the NFL, and it chronicles him basically being adopted by a family and getting him to where he is now. And he was he had troubled life growing up, mixing in with the wrong people, and a family took him in. They got kind of chronicle the recruiting process and him. Developing as a football player, getting into college, and culminating with him being drafted in the first round a few years ago. I think the family's name was Twitty.
I can't remember.
Yeah, I know. I can't remember the name off the top of my head. But Sandra Bullock played the mom in it. That's kind of the main protagonist, opposite of the Michael Oher character. But it won awards. And it's a very good movie, and it's football-related. I just liked everything about it. It's a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was a really good movie. Kind of like, unlike The Sandlot, which, you know, even though it makes up an ending, it's not a true story. The Rookie is loosely based on a true story, and The Blind Side is as well. And that's really cool. I kind of like that with sports. I think that's so many of the movies, and when I look at my list, a bunch of them are, you know, tied into true stories. That's kind of amazing when I sit there and think about it, because, one, you know, how many of them have those good endings? Well, which is why they're probably, those stories are picked to be movies
right.
to begin with. But it's a lot of fun just to kind of see, you know, some of these stories and avenues, like, through sports that I can relate to so much. You know, like, well, you know, there are very few things that I could relate to Michael Oher about, you know. But playing football, you know, now, again, I'm not calling myself, you know, an NFL caliber player, but I understand some idea what
short.
It's like to play football. You know what I mean? Other than that, we don't have a whole lot in common, you know. So, but being able to see how football, you know, played a major part in his life.
You
was,
don't
was
have
really
a Super
cool.
Bowl ring?
No, unfortunately. No. Thanks. You brought that up earlier this week as well. Thanks.
Different conversation. And also, that one is not safe for broadcast
Correct.
Radio.
Correct.
So, yeah, Blindside is my number 9, right. And I think it it was on your list to be considered.
Right. And in all reality, it could very easily make my list. I really do like that movie. It might be somewhat of an oversight on my part to not have it on there. I am going to go with another based on true story football movie for my number nine. One that hits home a little bit more. But instead of ending with a Super Bowl ring, it ends with a block punt return for a touchdown.
Hey,
or not a block punt. Sorry,
take what you can get.
Yeah, it ends with forcing a fumble and recovering it for a touchdown. But I'm going with Invincible. The Vince Papale story. I'd heard of him.
Disney.
I kind of knew the story. Yeah, but I didn't know a whole lot of it. Obviously, I know the movie is has some artistic license there.
They all have
but
to.
It was really cool. Again, I like at the end how they kind of give you a summary of what happens, and they show like the clip that the movie ends with, where he, calls an audible. I don't know that he called the audible, but that he goes and he, hits the guy and recovers the fumble for a touchdown on special teams. And then they show the clip of the actual game footage of
right.
a similar play. Now, it didn't happen exactly the same way, but of that play happening, that was really cool. Some of the movies don't, they take that and they kind of exaggerate a little bit for the point of the movie. Here, while they did that a little bit, the basis of that play was still really cool. And also, dealing with the Eagles and just the kind of the mentality
yeah.
that takes place in those other scenes is just so cool, because I can absolutely relate to so many of those scenes.
I think that movie gets drummed up a lot more in this area again because of the content of the movie.
Absolutely.
It's a good movie. It's fun. I'm not an Eagles fan, so when I'm watching it, I'm not looking through it the green glasses. But yeah, it's fun, and I like Mark Wahlberg though. So his portrayal in that's great, and seeing someone portray Dick Vermeil, it's a fun movie, and of course it has a happy ending, as they all do. Exactly. Disney and sports related movies, happy endings all around.
Thank goodness.
That one I saw but did not make my list, but it's definitely one that if it's on, I'll watch it. So my number eight, you've seen this one, I know.
Yeah.
And
I've only seen it in clips. I've never sat down and watched the whole thing through. I believe I've seen the entire movie.
Just not at one time.
Right, yeah.
And I tend to like sports movies that are either based on a true story or are comedies. There are some exceptions that we'll get to, but this one is pure comedy, made up, but is incredibly enjoyable, and that is Major League. I love Major League. It's really funny, even for how old it is now. The crude humor of it is
right.
great.
Again, some of the quotes thrown out this week all over the place on 50 Cent's first pitch.
Just a bit outside.
Right. Yeah.
And so, that's actually an actual Major League right. baseball announcer, Bob Uecker
yep.
of the Brewers, I believe. He did an incredible job being the Indians announcer. And any movie that will give hope to Cleveland, I have to applaud them for that.
And I think it might have been in Major League 2. I'm not sure. One of them.
Back to the Minors
was,
or whatever.
Right. Was filmed in Harrisburg on City Island.
Oh, was it? Really? Yeah. I didn't know that. So, yeah, Major League, it's great. Wild Thing, Charlie Sheen in that role is incredible. And I watched them do some of those things with the haircut and the glasses. And, someone was giving out, as in a minor league affiliation, was giving out the god that the guy...
Oh, yeah.
What's his name?
I know who
Yabu or something yeah. like that. They were giving out a bobblehead of him. Should have been an Indians association, some it's, kind of double A associate
yeah.
of the Cleveland Indians was
that
giving out. Yeah, man, that. But Major League is great. I love watching that one. It's old now and probably a little dated, but it's so much fun to watch. And definitely, you have to watch the unedited version. Don't watch the one on TV. The unedited version, the one that was out in the theaters. That's the one to watch. That one's really funny.
Yeah. My number eight, I went, again, another Disney movie, I believe.
There's a theme here.
Yeah. Would be Cool Runnings.
Again, and
based on a true story.
That is my number seven, so right. we just tie that in right there.
So, Cool Runnings, Jamaican bobsled team, I think that says it all.
Feel the rhythm, feel the
awesome.
Ride. Yeah, that one's a great one. It was... John Candy being in it made it what he's able to add to the film, and then having these guys run around in Jamaica or wherever they filmed it to
right.
actually have them make the Olympic Games from Jamaica for bobsledding.
My first year coaching, our team shirts had the saying "Kiss the lucky egg" on the back of them.
Yeah.
So yeah, Cool Runnings, great movie. Not the happiest of endings, but
you have the feel good part of it. Like everyone, they made it there. They were doing well. You know, they're being applauded by everyone at the end. You know, obviously, I'm sure everyone's seen it. It's like 20 years old now. You know, but obviously they crash on their last run, but they carry the sled across.
Yeah,
everyone's applauding them. You know, right. But they're still in the Olympics. Like, they're still a Jamaican bobsled team. They were there this year.
Right, and so. Cool Runnings. It was a great movie. It's another one. Like you said, when it's on, like I'll stop and kind of watch it. So that's a lot of fun.
Yeah. You can go dead. Right. Do your number seven
that
as well.
Was your number seven. Number seven. I'll be honest. The only reason it's probably number seven on my list is because of, in terms of, I just still have trouble considering it like a sport. It's a competition, I know, but it's obviously not a sport. But it deals with poker. And I figure since poker is shown on the mothership.
The mothership. The worldwide leader.
Right. I can definitely include it. It is Rounders. Again, Matt Damon and Norton is in it. It's a great movie. Let me rephrase. I really enjoy that movie. I really like it. It's a good movie. Matt Damon's trying to pay off some debt, and he's playing poker and, you know, all kinds of stuff. I'm not going to ruin the movie because I really want you to watch it.
So I know. I haven't seen it, so I need to see it.
That's one that I know you haven't seen, and it's not necessarily – it's not your typical sports movie at all, but because it includes poker and poker's, you know, included in the competitions and things like that, I absolutely definitely include it on my list, and I have it at number seven.
All right. Back to me, number six is a movie that we already talked about because it was part of the American Film Institute's top 10, and that is Caddyshack, and we talked about it a little, so I won't talk about it in depth now, but it really has a movie that's grown on me, and I don't know if it's just because it gets sentimental because Harold Ramis was the director, and I'm a huge Harold Ramis fan because of Ghostbusters, but I knew that he had directed it, but I didn't, I think I was taken for granted because everyone kind of talked it up. I don't like when something gets a ton of hype because I feel like the expectations are never met then. So Caddyshack was one of those movies that was always mentioned.
I'm kidding.
I honestly, Kelly and I refused to watch Avatar because of how much Greg talked about it.
I still haven't seen Avatar.
People just talked about it all the time, especially Greg, our music producer who's been on the show a couple times. And Kelly and I honestly have multiple chances to watch it. We even borrowed it from my sister, and we didn't watch it. We just let it sit
to say you haven't watched it.
Right. We just, it'd be sitting there.
One of the highest grossing movies of all time.
And the number one. Nope, haven't seen it.
Revitalized the 3D.
Right. Oh, that kind of made it huge and brought it to mainstream. But that's how I think I felt about Caddyshack the first few times I saw it because
everyone talks about how funny
great
it was.
Yeah, and I was just kind of sitting there like, okay, this is all
right. Right.
But I rewatched it a couple times in the last few years, and I just watched it a couple months ago after Harold Ramis passed away, and I have such a broader understanding and appreciation of the humor and what was going on. I've seen a couple behind the film things about it as well, and that makes it even better. So I definitely want you to watch Caddyshack. There's not really anything to give away because there's no real point to it. It's not based on anything, but Rodney Dangerfield, you know, Chevy Chase, Bill Murray, it's just really funny. You have to see it. And Caddyshack's my number six of my favorite sports movies of all time.
Just a quick side note. I feel like Caddyshack, from the clips that I have seen, I feel like Bill Murray, like, that could just be, like, part of
him?
His life. Like, he's not acting. Like, I talk about how, like, actors shouldn't, you know, get, like, all the praise when they play themselves. Like, for example, I always felt like Tom Cruise in Jerry Maguire, like, that's him. Like, you know,
he's
kind of,
crazy.
Kind of arrogant, you know, like, cocky, you know. Always, that may be unfair of me to judge Tom Cruise like that because I don't really know him, but...
Oh, we know him.
Right, yeah. You know what I mean? Like, I'm like, he's playing himself in that movie. Like, that's not acting. He's just, they're like, here, read these lines, you know, but just be yourself. I kind of feel like that might be Bill Murray in Caddyshack.
Yeah, I remember Harold Ramis said on the one behind the scenes thing that they didn't even know if the movie was going to be made because Bill doesn't sign contracts. He wasn't at the set like a day or two before they were supposed to start filming his scenes. He showed up. He didn't like go by the script at all. Like he just kind of off. And apparently him and Chevy Chase didn't get along after something that happened on Saturday Night Live, I guess. And there wasn't a point in the movie originally that they interacted, not because of the little mini feud that they had. It just wasn't in the script, and they were like, we need to have these two guys do a scene, and there's a scene in the movie that you're just like it kind of feels forced that you're just like, get these two together to see what happens, but I don't want to give away anymore. But yeah, Caddyshack, that's one of my favorites.
Yeah. So for my number six, I have Miracle. Which, again, it could easily be higher on my list. I didn't really rank them as strictly as I would have, but it probably would have taken a full extra week to actually sit down and do that.
We probably would have to watch all of them again.
Right, right. Miracle is a great movie. Again, happy ending. We beat the Russians. So it's based
on a true story.
Like, by those standards, Rocky IV should also be on the list. But this one actually happened. But again, the underdog who beats like the best in the world, you know, it's a true story. Again, it shows the real clips. It shows all those things. It's got all the makings of a great, you know, sports movie. Also, Disney.
Disney. And I was noting, as you were pointing that out, Rookie Disney, Invincible Disney, Cool Runnings Disney, Miracle Disney. There's one more that's Disney on your list.
I did that with True Story on mine. I went, True Story, True Story, True Story.
Maybe we should see Million Dollar Arms or whatever just came out. Right. That is a Disney movie with John Hamm and two Indian boys that apparently made the major leagues at some point.
I don't think they've made it, but they're in the minors. In the pirate system.
In the pirate system?
The one is not. The one still is, though. Yeah.
But that's that just came out, I think, on Friday.
Yeah.
So maybe Disney has another sports hit, because clearly there's a theme here. I think half of our lists are made up of Disney-related movies. Okay. So your number six was Miracle. Miracle is on my list, but we'll wait a few more titles until it makes an appearance on mine. Number five is kind of one of the lone exceptions on my list where I said I like comedies or based on true stories. This one is neither. It's actually a true like drama, and it's made up. Probably not something that the NFL likes to be out there. I know it gets panned all the time, and I think it was tried to be a more modern version of an older sports film. And I'm not sure it succeeded, but I didn't see the original, so I can't comment on that. But I really enjoyed Any Given Sunday because of, you know, just the theme of the entire movie. I know it's out there, and I know it's probably too vulgar for a lot of people, but it's, I don't know, there's just something that, as I watched it a couple of times, that I really enjoyed. And it has a classic character, and Willie Beeman is the name, the quarterback in the movie. He goes from being a nobody to a starter, and that, of course, goes to his head. And Al Pacino plays the coach. It's very crude. It's probably not one that I would think many women would enjoy, but it's something that I think if you're a football fan, you should at least give it a try. And I've heard, I think you mentioned it too, and I've seen it before, that people were saying it was kind of trying to be this, a more updated version of North Dallas 40. And I haven't seen that one, but I enjoyed Any Given Sunday, and I feel like I need to watch it again. But it makes my list. Again, we tried to put them in order. I don't know if it should be as high as number five, but I enjoyed it, and I know there's a lot of people that didn't, but I did.
Yeah, and again, that's one that I haven't seen. You know, but again, I hear a lot of people talk about it. A lot of people have seen it, so you know, at some point I wouldn't mind seeing it just to kind of be able to understand kind of, you know, more of the talk about it. My number five, again, true story, or based on true story, based on the book. I read the book as well. Friday Night Lights. Really like the story. It's a good movie. I thought it was done really well. I thought so. Well, yeah, again, it's over 10 years. It's like 10 years old. Almost 10 years old.
Yeah,
so,
it came out in 2004,
and it's also
a
true story, so I don't feel like it's really a spoiler at that point. Not the happy ending that you hope for. It's kind of sad and depressing.
Yeah.
But
you see how big football is in Texas.
It's really good. Yeah, and it's a really good story and movie just in general. So I really like Friday Night Lights. If you haven't seen it, I would recommend it.
Friday Night Lights, the name is awesome, first of all. Friday Night Lights, and especially if you're a high school football fan, Friday Night Lights is like that exactly how you feel. Like that everyone is there to watch you. This is a huge thing for the town because it's not professional. You know, it's not even college. It's small school, young kids, children trying to find their way. There's all these off the field things happening, and in the book and the movie, one of the characters' name is Booby.
Yeah, that's true. Booby Miles.
I remember when I was watching the movie, I was like, "That's an interesting name for a child."
That's obviously one of those names nickname. Where I'm like, "Man, you've got to be tough." Because with a nickname like that, you have to be tough. So, but yeah, great movie. If you haven't seen it, I would recommend going to see that. You could also read the book. The book's really good too. But
I wouldn't give money to him.
I know. I had the book already. I had the book, and I've seen the movie before.
Right. No, I understand. I didn't read the book. I saw the movie. But yeah, I mean, it's enjoyable. It's a lot of fun, and I think a lot of kids and even adults can relate to things from back when they were in high school. It's definitely an interesting movie. It was really close to making my list. I've seen it multiple times, and I definitely enjoy it as well. My number four, here we go, Disney again. Hop on board. This one's actually a trilogy. But nothing will top the original, The Mighty Ducks.
Heck yeah!
And Emilio Estevez is the man. He what a great role for him, hockey coach, Triple Deke. You know, all the great stuff. Gordon Bombay. Those jerseys are just one of the ugliest things I've ever seen.
They were awesome.
They're so ugly that they're incredible, and I want to own one. Yes. Charlie Conway. That's you know. It's
ducks fly together.
Ducks fly together, right? Quack, quack, quack. You know, and I think it's great that Goldberg, the goalie, is a Flyers fan.
Absolutely.
I asked someone about it. Is the TV show The Goldbergs based on, like, did they grab the name Goldberg from that? Because they're based in Philly, I think. They're all Philly sports fans on that show.
I've got to watch it.
So
now.
I was thinking, I was like, maybe this is all tied together somehow. But yeah, The Mighty Ducks, they're number four. If that movie's on, I will sit down and watch it. Because I absolutely love that movie. I enjoy the second one, too, because you get everything in, you know, essentially the Olympics. And instead of playing Russia, they play Iceland, of all places. But, you know, you get to have the... See them in those. Now, those are crazy jerseys. Those USA jerseys they wear, those are nuts. But, you know, they get to play like these Iceland and Trinidad Tobago or something like that. Yeah. Just thinking of all these crazy, crazy schools that they have play. But I really enjoy the Mighty Ducks series, and the original is one of my favorite of all time.
I would have to agree. While it didn't make my top 10, it's absolutely up there, and it was... It is a great movie, and like nostalgic to like my childhood too. Like, oh man,
how many movies inspire a franchise?
Yeah,
Disney bought a hockey team to name the Mighty Ducks. Now Disney doesn't own them anymore, and they're not Mighty anymore. They're just the Anaheim Ducks. But they literally had a hockey team based on from the first movie.
Located in Anaheim, they have a hockey team in Anaheim.
And when Disney still owned them, they wore the jerseys from the second movie.
Right.
Like, those jerseys were in the movie. Like, that was...
I think I had one of those
what
jerseys.
What an incredible logo, too. That was an incredible logo.
Like, the duck mask?
Yeah, the duck goalie mask. That was brilliant.
Yeah.
And they actually had a cartoon of it, too.
Yeah.
That is nuts right there. That is childhood throwback right there. That there was not only the three movies, there was an actual hockey team called the Mighty Ducks, and there was the Mighty Ducks TV show animated that they were like superheroes.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy.
It has it all. All right, what about you? What was my number four?
My number four is 42. Jackie Robinson, obviously. More recent, I saw it. It was a really good movie. Kind of gives you more insight into kind of just the mindset and some of the ridiculous stuff that he had to deal with. And obviously, you know, the movie is just like the tip of the iceberg, you know, when you think about it. It's one of those when you're like, it's more impactful because you know it's a true story. And you're just like, oh my gosh, that's terrible. But that's what makes it a good story is the fact that, you know, he kind of overcame that. Jackie Robinson got a lot of talk when we're talking about our best ofs, you know, in terms of baseball and different positions and things like that. People forget how phenomenal of an athlete he was. I think lettering in all three sports at USC. So pretty amazing. So that's a good one. More recent, if you haven't seen it, go.
Yeah, that actually, and I said to you that I was, that was probably the next sports movie I'm going to see is 42. I've been waiting to see it, and hopefully I'll be able to do that soon. Quickly here, as we're running out of time.
Yeah, we'll speed this
number up. Three is Varsity Blues for me. I just enjoy that. It just sit down there. I laugh so hard at it. You know, it's probably a little bit out there, but again, Texas football is chronicled. You know, it's not based on a true story, but comedy and quotability, and that, to me, that Varsity Blues has that through the roof. So I really, really enjoy Varsity Blues.
Yeah, definitely one, you know, that I've seen lots of times. You know, kind of like a classic. I don't remember exactly when it came out, but I think we were in high school when it
we
came
were in
out.
Eighth or ninth. I was in eighth or ninth grade, because I remember, like, that was the big thing in the football locker room was Varsity Blues.
So I remember, you know, when that came out. My number three, again, another high school football movie, was Remember the Titans.
And that's actually my number two.
Right. Great, great movie. You know, difficult, you know, in terms of, like, doesn't necessarily go exactly how you would like it to go at the end. But, you know, going back to, you know, a true story, you know.
Right.
Loosely
based on the true story. T.C. Williams High School.
You know, things are like, man, that kind of stinks. But because it's true, that kind of adds to the story. It adds to that, you know, that impact that the story kind of makes on you.
Yeah, the ending is incredibly sad, but throughout the entire movie, like, there's a lot that happens, a lot of great times. Denzel Washington's great in it.
Yeah.
Hayden Panettiere makes the debut there. She was like 9 or 10 years old, and I believe Larry Johnson Sr. was a head coach there for a couple seasons.
I think he was.
Right, T.C. Williams in Virginia.
I think he played for Coach Boone.
Did he?
Yeah, or coached with him, something like that. Like, he was maybe not at the time of the movie.
Right.
At some point, he coached with him or played for him or something like that along those lines. So, yeah, I know that tie is there somewhere.
Yeah, left side, strong side.
Yeah. My number two.
Disney movie, by the way.
So, your number two is Remember the Titans. That was my number three. My number two is Hoosiers. I can't see it enough. I love it. Kind of when I was reading through things, I agree. It has everything. It has the underdog. It has, you know, the new coach who wants to change ways. It has the star who doesn't want to play but changes his mind. It has the dad who's not the best influence who kind of keeps getting in the way. It's got, you know, all these different, like, things that kind of come into one movie. And it's just, I just absolutely love it. Maybe part of it is too, like, I grew up, you know, from 3rd grade to 10th grade, I grew up in a small town that was always kind of the underdog. Basketball was the biggest sport, like, always playing, like, bigger
called
schools.
Out to you.
Like, yeah, like, it, this movie spoke to me, and I absolutely loved it. Also, in the movie, it's the same colors. Also, based on a true story.
Right.
And I don't know if it's still this way, but up until very recently, Indiana, like, basketball state championships are still not decided by class. They have different classes, but they have a tournament where every school is in the tournament. The small schools play the big schools.
Wow.
It's for the true state.
That's
champion.
Awesome. I didn't know about that. Yeah, I've seen Hoosiers, but it was a long time ago. I need to see it again, definitely.
Oh, it's awesome.
Now, my number one was already mentioned because it was on your list, I believe, at number six. And
my number one was on your list.
Right.
Too,
so my number one will start here. I'm going to play a clip of it. Just listen.
Great moments are born from great opportunity. And that's what you have here tonight, boys. That's what you've earned here tonight. One game. If we played them 10 times, they might win 9. But not this game. Not tonight. Tonight, we skate with them. Tonight, we stay with them. and we shut them down because we can. Tonight, we are the greatest hockey team in the world. You were born to be hockey players. Every one of you. And you were meant to be here tonight. This is your time. Their time is done. It's over. I'm sick and tired of hearing about what a great hockey team the Soviets have. Screw them. This is your time. Now go out there and take it.
Okay, so that obviously was Miracle. The Disney movie that you had number six, I have number one. It's my favorite. And, that speech ended up eventually leading to this moment.
10 seconds. The countdown going on right now. Morrow, up to Schultz. 5 seconds left in the game. You believe in miracles? Yes!
So, we all know how it ends. We talked about it a couple months ago when we were watching the most recent Olympics in Russia. The U.S. team at the time was doing well, and they faltered towards the end. But it's brought up every 4 years. It's what we said a few months ago, I think, obviously still stands. It's probably the greatest moment in American sports history.
Yeah, I mean, when you look at what it meant beyond the sports realm.
Right, because of all else that was going on.
Right, just because of everything that happened, games that we almost, boycotted, or they boycotted, just
there's always something more.
Right. It was just absolutely insane, and all the things that were going on with it, and they still were able to kind of make sure that the way they came together and won that game and beat the best team in the world.
Yeah.
Herb Brooks probably had it right when he was saying that, they might not win that game
any other time they play it
out of 10 times, right?
Or 100.
Right, yeah. They're not the better team. They weren't. They were that one night, and that's
one time,
all you needed.
It's all
right.
It needs. And Kurt Russell played Herb Brooks absolutely amazingly. It was to the T. Herb Brooks died tragically probably close to 10 years ago now. It was right around, I think, right after the movie came out, maybe.
Yeah. I think it was right before.
Was it right before?
Yeah.
And, Kurt Russell, I think, just did such a great job portraying him in the movie. And I love that movie. I can't get enough of it. And so that's my number one. Now, your number one is one that I actually started with, and we'll cut right to the chase.
And a fat kid, Rodriguez.
Shut your mouth, Phillips.
What'd you say, crab face?
I said you shouldn't even be allowed to touch a baseball. Except for Rodriguez, you're all an insult to the game.
Come on! We'll take you on right here, right now! Come on! Yeah!
We plan a real diamond, Porter. You ain't good enough to lick the dirt off our cleats.
Watch it, jerk.
Shut up, idiot.
Moron!
Scab eater.
Butt sniffer.
Yeah!
Pus licker. Fart smeller.
You eat dog crap for breakfast, geek.
You mix your weeds with your mama's toe jam.
Yeah!
You bob for apples in the toilet, and you like it.
You play ball like a girl.
What did you say?
You heard me.
Tomorrow. Noon, at our field. Get the buffalo butt breath.
Count on it, pee-drinking crap face.
Yeah!
Let's go!
I don't know if there's a movie that I can, I say relate to. It's not exactly the same. However, I remember the summers when I was in elementary school, like late elementary school, we played baseball every day on the playground, and then we would go to the pool. Maybe that's
maybe
that's how I could relate so much to The Sandlot. It was just an awesome, I don't know, there's just something about it that draws me in every single time. If it is on, I watch it.
Yeah,
I
absolutely a great movie. Love
it. It just, it kind of, it definitely, you know, pulls some on some ties that I have back to my childhood. So, Sandlot came in at my number one. But again, there were so many great sports movies. A lot that I still want to see that I haven't seen, and we'll have to work on that and maybe revisit our not necessarily an updated list, but you know, kind of like
recap the ones that we hadn't seen yet.
Right. So see if that influences our top 10 at all.
Yeah, definitely. All right, so that's it. That wraps up episode 136. That's our take on sports movies. If you get to watch this on demand, send us an email. Let us know what your list is, or what we overlooked, or what you disagree, or what you agree on. And on next week's episode, we'll be back on Sunday, June 8th. We'll be doing a Phillies update. Might not be a great show. Might be a little somber, a little gloomy. But we'll talk about Phillies and get you caught up to speed with what's been going on with them.
Yeah, so hopefully they can... Well, who knows?
Who knows?
I don't even know. I was going to try and say something positive.
But you just
like
can't.
I always do about the Phillies. I'm always the last one to jump off the bandwagon. And it might be a lonely, long summer. But
yeah, really. Again.
All right. So that pretty much wraps up our movie episode.
I got a couple shout-outs here, a couple birthdays. College friend Eric Wirtz, he worked with me on Sports Fountainhead before the show started here. He's got a birthday today. Happy birthday to him. Tomorrow is Brent's birthday, a good friend of ours. Happy birthday to him as well. And as well as my aunt this week, Aunt Glow, she has a birthday she'll be celebrating. So happy birthday to the three of them. And I also want to congratulate my wife. Kelly ran her first 5K today. So
yeah,
very proud that she was awesome. Able to take to the task and get that done. I think she was happy with the results, and hopefully she'll run another one.
Yeah, that's awesome. It's kind of funny how that's kind of picked up in our group of friends. So.
Yeah, anything that you need to add?
Not that I can think of.
All right, then I think that's it. Thanks for joining us. That wraps up the 136th episode of the Joe Mays and J-Raff Show.
We hope you tune in every Sunday evening at 6:30 for our take on sports. Until next time, I'm J-Raff.
And I'm Joe Mays. Thanks for listening.
Thanks for listening to the Joe Mays and J-Raff Show. Don't forget, you can download each episode of the show from the podcast section of the iTunes store. We'll see you next time, and thanks again for listening.